It's the Go Kart Brothers MMO Show podcast.
That's awesome. That's better than we've ever had.
It's Go Kart Brothers MMO Show podcast.
It's the Go Kart Brothers MMO Show podcast. Hi.
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 Oh, wait, there's a voice coming from somewhere.
That's me.
We do have a mystery voice.
Under the table.
I'm the guy.
From the powers that be that I am channeling through
the MMO
amazing
show.
Cosmic energies that we only have access to due to the fact that Go Kart Brothers MMO Show podcast is happening.
Are we going to put this on both feeds? Is that the...
I don't know, actually, that's a good idea. We should, maybe. Maybe.
Or we need to drink more and come up with another podcast. So we came up with this one the first time, I think. So if y'all had
that didn't go over too good.
Went over great. We got your L's, Twitter accounts, Facebooks.
Charlie's cute little buttons.
Buttons. I now have a logo on my hoodie.
Adorable buttons.
And I'm about to be able to wear it again because it's getting cold.
Bam. It's not focusing.
Oh,
you get the idea.
Hit on my face. Hit on my face. What so if y'all have a good weekend or week.
Buttons.
The MMO show.
Yeah. You're trying to start this. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No. It's you're starting it. It's that's how it goes.
We should introduce the voice that cannot be seen. Who is that? Who are you, Mystery
Voice?
It's me. And who are you?
I'm Jason.
Yeah, that's Jason.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey.
That's me, Mario.
Jason.
Say the MMO show, Jason.
Say MMO show.
Some good stuff there.
Oh, and I'm Shannon, and we also have tonight on the show...
Brent.
It's me, Jason. Brent,
yeah. Oh. That was smooth. Look how smooth we are. We're good at this now.
We're pros.
We're so smooth. We're need to edit.
We started late again, all my fault.
No, maybe not. Kind of. I was doing my makeup. That's fine.
Well, I was playing Minecraft. Haven't done
I
that
actually
in a year.
Have Minecraft going.
No, you can't do that. You're the one who yells at us for doing that. You can't do that.
Yeah.
That's true.
I just disconnected.
Okay.
I just heard the music, and I'm like, that's cool. He's channeling in the music. And I'm like, no, that's me. I left Minecraft on.
That's my bad. That's how things go on the MMO show.
So, yeah, for those who don't know, we do two shows. We do Go Kart Brothers, and we do the MMO show. Actually, we do more shows than that. But that's the show that all of the hosts here do together. But we really don't do... MMO show and Go Kart Brothers, we always do or. I would say it's an or situation.
Yeah.
Because
almost seasonal.
Because we kind of started doing Go Kart Brothers and we totally quit doing the MMO show. And someone asked me the other day, like, when are you guys going to do the MMO show? I thought this was just like a thing. And it's like, that's a good point. Like, I'm not really sure. Because we only do one or the other. So we don't really have a whole thing to do both. There's.
And we kind of paused because there wasn't really an MMO to play. No one was
Yeah.
We weren't playing the same one, at least, I guess.
No, I think none of us were playing MMOs for a couple weeks there. And it was like, but I want a podcast but not and talk about all the other stuff I'm doing. And so we didn't feel like we had a lot of freedom.
Freedom!
Free bird. I
gotta
freedom! Be free as a bird, y'all.
So you say you gotta be free? So you say you gotta be me?
This bird you cannot change.
That's a song, I think.
Yeah, but no one's ever heard of that song.
That's
the new hot song.
People
not
say
like it's a famous song.
People
so.
Say play this song. Play Free Bird. Free that was Free
anyway,
Bird, right?
Everyone likes Free Bird. There's like not a person in the world that doesn't like Free Bird.
And pretty much every musician in the world hates Free Bird.
Really?
Yeah, because every time they play, there's one redneck in the audience who goes, "Play Free Bird!" And they're like, oh, man.
That's because everyone likes Freebird.
Yeah. It's weird.
Yeah.
Or it may just be a southern thing. Maybe they don't do that up north. Like, when you're up north, does someone inevitably yell out, play Freebird? Like, not like if you're at Def Leppard.
I'm like, if I'm like...
But if you're at like some...
If I'm like at Deftones, no. It never has happened.
It may just be a southern thing.
I'm not sure I go to the concerts where people would yell that. So, I don't know.
Well, you should. It's an experience. Yeah. Especially if they pull out Freebird and start playing it.
That would be crazy.
Yeah.
I don't know if the Deftones could do Freebird, but that would be amazing.
Is that like a ska band? I've heard of the Deftones.
No, they're not ska.
No.
Anyway.
What are they? Oh, something flashed. Are you still there?
Yeah, I'm there.
This is the MMO show.
It's the MMO show. It's Go Kart Brothers.
Apparently,
it's Go Kart Brothers of MMO show. We don't even know which one we're gonna put this on tonight. I guess.
We got the Go Kart Brothers logo.
There you go.
But
exciting factor.
We can probably change that.
Nah, you know, you can flip it to whatever you want to do. I don't care.
Right, flip it.
Smack it, rub it down. Oh no, the girl's gonna do me.
That's another song, isn't it?
No.
Oh.
Yeah, it is.
I swear I've heard that before.
What's with this show?
Right? This is how
I'm sitting here listening. You guys are giving me garbage.
Oh, damn.
Ow.
Damn.
Ow. All right, well, Jason, what do you want to talk about tonight? You know what, Jason? Give us your week in gaming. What have you been doing?
Playing some Legion. World of Warcraft.
I've heard of that. It's a big MMO, right? That's one of the more popular
ones. I guess.
Ones.
I mean, I don't know.
It's a thing.
All right. You don't really follow trends.
No, but... I don't really know. I mean, I saw it on the shelf. I picked it up.
So Legion is their latest expansion?
Mm-hmm. I guess it's what's on the shelf at Target.
At Target? Yeah, they have a PC section at Target. Do they?
It up. Yes, they do.
Yeah, and they have the boxes for this there? Because that's amazing.
You don't even have to take a ticket.
No, I don't think there's boxes of Legion around. I've heard they're extremely hard to find because they didn't really do a lot of them.
Yeah, but I mean, Target's got them.
Oh, that's true. They had exclusive Target launch. Target.
I just know. That's where I picked it up. I'm like, I'm going to look into this.
It's cool.
I looked into it. It's not bad.
Hmm.
Pretty good
stuff.
Well,
can you be more specific about what you did so far?
I've leveled some artifacts and seen some environments, and I've made some newbies, and
I've done
some dungeons. I've done a lot of it.
You liked all that?
Yeah, it's all been a little bit of fun. That adds up to a lot of fun.
This is not giving any information though. Here, like, what do you mean? Like,
I don't know.
I've got a question though.
All right.
Like, when WoW came out. If I remember correctly, y'all didn't really play WoW. Y'all were playing something else at the time?
No, I played a launch. I was in beta and played a launch.
We played Dark Age Camelot prior to World of Warcraft, but at World of Warcraft, you had an early access beta. Like, we were already switched over. Like, we were ready to go.
Okay.
Like, day... I think it was... Like, the first thing we did was we made our guild on Silverhand, on Alliance, and Circle of Trust. Still there. It still exists. I don't think anyone actually plays, but my character is still in that guild. So, you know, we've been there since the beginning, but what happened was I was pregnant at the time. So, and so, like, a month before launch, like, we still managed to get in-game and get the guild going, and we thought we could do this whole being parents thing and having a baby thing simultaneously wouldn't be a big deal. But then the baby, there were complications with the baby. And so the baby was in
all broken
NICU for like 6 months. And so we were living and sleeping in the hospital. Yeah, like,
they wouldn't let you bring your rig in there?
No.
Like, I got a raid.
They had one little computer you could use their Wi-Fi, but it was like email. So it's like I would email and like message people on the forums. And just be like, guys, we're out of this thing.
Yeah.
So by the time we got into WoW, really, like, because when he came home still, it was like all this healthcare stuff we had to do. So by the time we actually got into WoW, like, it had been, like, we kind of piecemealed throughout there trying to keep going, and it was just a mess. We couldn't keep up with everybody. And then by the time we could devote time to it, everyone who was into WoW was, like, so far beyond us.
Right.
And already, right. like, had managed some sort of alliance to do raiding and stuff. And then...
And that was back when it was more difficult to, like, level up and stuff. Like, yeah, now yeah, you yeah. can just level up so easy. But back then it would took, like, you know, months.
A majillion like, was, years. Yeah.
Like, people were like, oh, you need, like, 10 gold for this. And you're like, 10 gold? I will never have 10 gold.
How am I going to get 10 gold? Like...
And now you poop it out. You're like, oh!
Live in the game to get 10
gold. Gold.
Yeah.
Slash poop.
10 gold on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So then we come back. We tend to come back every... anyway, new shiny MMOs came out, and we were like, well, we could start fresh there. And so we kind of started that habit. And then the thing is, though, like, World of Warcraft, it's really good. And so almost every expansion, we come back, at least for a little while, a month or two. And so this one, I will say, too, like, I came back, and I'm... Usually what I do is I roll up some noobs, and I never even see... the expansion content, like, if unless they're giving me a new race, like, I don't see this expansion content at all. And so this time they gave a new character, but it was like, oh, but that's a really high level, I don't know if I really want to get involved at that high level. But right. they also gave us the opportunity to boost a character, and you were on a server that we had never played on before, and you insist on playing Horde. So what we decided yes. to do was boost a Horde, and we never really got too invested in Horde. We played with a group for a little while, but not to end game levels. So anyway,
I won't hold that against you. I understand sorry. How it can happen.
So then, anyway, I used my I played. I don't even know if I mentioned this in the last show or not. It's been so long, but I played the invasions and got a character to 60. Claimed her trade skills so that when I boosted her, her trade skill crafting crap got boosted too. I don't know. Is it crafting or trade skills? Doesn't really matter. Same thing.
Same thing. You got
we
it.
All know what I'm saying. So, yeah. So that got boosted too. And so then I've done 2 zones and I think I'm like 106. But then I got distracted making baby characters too.
That's okay. Yeah. That happens.
But I'm having a good time. Did some dungeons and stuff. And
yeah, we did some lower level dungeons, and that was a lot of fun.
Uh-huh.
Apparently, I'm not very good as a healer. Sorry.
Oh, you did great. It was probably that group you signed up with earlier.
That's the anxiety, though. Yeah.
I don't know, because I saw a tweet by Sim, who was with us, and he's like, well, you know, getting into WoW and carrying your friends through dungeons. He goes, but it's always fun with Zelly and App. I'm like, oh!
I don't think he meant it like that.
Oh, sorry. He might have, because it was pretty bad. But anyway.
No.
It's okay. It can't be the worst. And if I am, that's amazing to be the worst. So.
Well, yeah. I mean, there should be an achievement for being the absolute worst.
That's at least something.
Maybe not one you want to share with people, but an achievement.
I would share. I don't care. Anyway. So... Brent, what are you enjoying lately with MMOs?
The MMO show.
MMO.
I've been playing WoW, of course. I wasn't even sure I was going to, like, play it. I kind of got roped into the expansion because of some issues with my son's account. And I had to.
Because they're linked, right?
Well, yeah, but they originally were both my accounts. And I had, like, filled up the account that he used with a bunch of characters, and so he couldn't make characters on it. And I was like, I'll tell you what, I will pay to have one moved off of there. But I'd already bought him the expansion, and they have some weird thing where if one has the expansion, you can't trade from that one to, like, one that doesn't have the expansion. So I had to buy the expansion just to transfer a character. So one transfer ended up costing, like, almost $100, right? Like, something stupid. But anyway, so... I felt like I had to play at that point, and I'm really glad I did. This is probably one of the best expansions they've done.
Why?
I think once you get to the end, I mean, the story, they're always pretty decent with the story. story's not anything spectacular. But now with like the world quests, I think they actually work kind of well, and how they did the kind of final zone, Suramar, keeps you kind of invested in coming back. And so it's, there's still stuff to do at the end. And apparently they'll be releasing Karazhan real soon, which y'all have to do that one. That was one of the ultimate raids. And I think it's like a five-man dungeon now or something crazy. I don't know.
So you're saying I have to keep sticking with this?
Yeah, you don't have to. I mean, you can quit if you want. But
no,
you know, quitters never win.
I don't want to. I just... Well, that's fine. All right with that.
I would love to take both of y'all on like a raid. Like, it, like
is it the, great?
It's just... It's because it's like you and like 10 of your guildies. And so it's like fun just... spending time together, whether you get the mob or not, who cares?
I like that attitude. See, I don't like the attitude where people want me to do well. Like, that sucks.
it's about like spending time together, right?
So much work.
I mean, there is a time to like go with people and be like, okay, this is super serious and we're gonna go take this boss down and we're gonna do
that drop, so we're serious now. Yeah,
but doing like, you know, just some fun guild runs is good stuff. And cool. We can even do like a raid finder, which those are they're a lot easier, so it's like it really doesn't matter. You just kind of chill out. But yeah, no, it's been fun. I'm trying to think anything else that was fun.
It's been a while since we did a show, so it's kind of hard to like think like all of the games we've been into since. But pretty much, it's like WoW, and it's kind of. I played some Sotor a bit too, but not enough to even comment on it.
Right. Yeah, I haven't played any other MMOs. It's been more like this week I've played some Hearthstone and some Overwatch. I played Paladins tonight for the first time in a while.
Ooh, I saw them hitting the Twitter hard.
And it's a lot like Overwatch now. I mean, for good or bad, it's a lot more fun than it was.
Good.
And if you bought the beta and played in the closed beta, I would say go back because it's almost like a new game. So it's almost like you bought two games for one. So go back and play it again like it's a game you've never played before.
That's by Hi-Rez, right?
Yeah.
I like the Hi-Rez dudes. They're nice dudes.
Yeah, they are. They are.
They were really cool. Once in one of our old podcasts, we interviewed them when they made Global Agenda and prior to that launch. And they were awesome. They were really cool.
Talk to Todd, I think, right?
Yeah.
He's the head honcho.
Yeah, him and another... Who's the other guy? This is terrible of me. I don't think... Wow. I don't know. I wasn't really that involved. Huh?
I said, wow.
I got it on YouTube. I could go look at it.
It was a long time ago.
It was Global Agenda.
I mean, it was Global Agenda launch. It was a long time ago.
The game that never happened, so...
It did happen. We had a guild and everything. It happened.
I thought it... Well, it's shut down then, right?
It's shut down. Okay. Yeah, but it happened.
But just beta, right? It never actually got released.
No, it launched.
Not really, though.
No, like, yeah, it was pay to play. Like tribes too. Free to play. Yeah, it was a pay. It was like a buy to play, I think, wasn't it? Or was there a sub? I don't even remember.
I think you're thinking of a different game now.
Nope, I remember. It was like almost all instance. There was like a hub, and then everything was instance.
Yeah, Global Agenda you're talking
about,
right?
Final Fantasy 14.
No.
Before they remade it. That's not what she's talking about.
Before they remade it. Hi-Rez
does it all.
Like, because didn't they just have a hub?
No.
I'm just fucking with you.
No, they have a world. They have a really good world.
Mm-hmm. Global Agenda?
No. Global Agenda did not have a world. They had a lot of instanced areas that you and your friends would play. And that was cool. But
there were some robots.
The hard part was, though, like, if you weren't in an instance with doing stuff, like, you were kind of limited to what, like, there's just, like, a hub. So it was a good weekly, like, to just kind of, like, plan out with your buddies. But then other than that, you know, that's where it lost its...
charm?
It
didn't have charm, really.
It had charm. I lost my motivation to like stick with it.
You know who he looks like?
Who's he?
Todd.
Oh, who?
The dude from Full House.
You think so?
Yeah.
Dave Coulier?
Yes.
Really?
No, the other dude. The Bob Saget. Bob Saget, yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's like, yeah, that's a Todd name. Todd would look like. I'm surprised it's not Todd Saget.
Well, it's so much so that during the they like Hi Rez made like a video that was a spoof of Full House.
Uh-huh.
It was basically the Full House intro, you know, and at the end Todd's know, in there. So
was it good?
It's funny. It's funny.
That's cute. Sounds good.
I like that. And it's, you know, when your CEO will hop in and do that sort of stuff, it's
that's cool.
It's good stuff. See there that's he is. Cool. There's Todd.
Oh yeah, I could see that. Sorry, we had audio. We were not video back then.
Oh. What's going on? Well, we'll add him over here. We'll go up here. Please.
Bye, Todd.
No, he's still here. Oh, you can't see him. I'll put him over here so you can see him.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
He'll be above you.
Oh, great.
It'll be like you're thinking about him.
He's on my shelf.
He is. You've got a picture of Bob Saget on your shelf. It's a huge Bob Saget fan, aren't you? Hey, tell you, that's Todd Harris.
Big. So. Big fan.
Yeah.
Big fan. Anyway. So, well, there's another game I know you've been playing as of today, right?
Are you referring to Minecraft?
I'm referring to Minecraft. So
you're playing it. You're playing it more than I am.
I barely played. Oh, so because I haven't been playing Minecraft at all, my group that I really, really love, but I don't have time for them, they kind of messaged me about my inactivity, and it's like, I can't really promise that I'll play more. So I was like, yeah, let me remove me, because they kind of like have a limited number on their whitelist, and they want active people participating in the group and being a part of events and stuff. And they have a lot of events, which is great because it's exactly what I want, but I just can't really do it right now. So, so I contacted you yesterday. I'm like, hey, do you have that server? Because you mentioned before like you had a server, and I thought it was like a thing that was going. So then I felt bad, because then it seemed like you started it up just because I crabbed at you about it, and it was like, I didn't mean to do that.
I've been wanting to like get it going. I just haven't really had a reason to, because no one's wanted to play Minecraft, and I've had this grand plan of doing like this like short 10 episode season of The Shaft, just to see where Minecraft is, like, you know, a year. Probably almost 2 years now later since the last show, and get some people on it and talk about it. But I need to play it.
Yeah. You got to get a skeleton horse and stuff. I'm not really sure what else has happened.
Polar bear. There's polar bears.
There are? I didn't know there were polar bears.
I see these things and I'm like, polar bears. And then I play and they added in the thing that they, so on the mobile devices, they had the auto jump going up blocks, and they don't have to jump going up a block.
Yeah.
So annoying.
I don't like that at all.
I hate it.
That's like not. I'm already like it's messing up my Twitch. It's like no. Bouncing all over the place.
Your Twitch skills.
Yeah, my Minecraft Twitch skills. My mad accurate Twitch Minecraft.
You hopping in there, Jason? Did you ever do the Minecraft thing?
I might actually. I was telling Chan earlier. I might hook up VR and get into that server.
Well, I'll up the difficulty.
Yes, I like it hard.
She likes it hard.
That's like what Jason really told me.
I know. That's actually what I just said, though.
Yeah.
She likes it hard.
Hard to normal. It's. You set it up on easy, and I'm like I ran inside at night. I'm like freaking out, thinking like they're gonna bust through the door, and I got my sword ready, and they didn't even come to the door. And I'm like, what the heck? And I went outside, and I'm like, there's like two dudes that come at me and a spider, and I'm like, I got a wooden sword, and I'm killing them. Like, this is in danger. I want it hard survival. And
you want it real hard?
Yeah, like. The harder the better. I was on a server once and they bumped up, they had some sort of mod, and they bumped up like the zombie apocalypse level. And so you had to, like, if you could get off the spawn mountain, if. And then, like, you had to, like, kind of keep running it, and you'd die and keep running and die. And then eventually you'd find, like, a little pocket, and you'd get out. And then you had to, like, run out and then run as far as you could. And then you dig and then, like, bury yourself into a mountain real quick. And then you have to figure out, like, okay, how do I get wood? And, like, you're trying to, like, sneak out and back in because you're in a dark area, too. It was, like, this crazy, crazy experience. And Slurms was there with me at the time. And we, like, found the same cave and everything. And it was nuts. But, unfortunately, the problem with Minecraft is you'll find these really cool little communities doing something like that. But then it was the 16-year-old kid running it. And he was, like, for 3 days, he forgot to turn it on, and it's like you lost momentum, you know.
Right.
So then it's like, well, you know, fine. I don't know when you're on or not. But he had a great idea. He was just this kid that was completely unreliable for running the actual server. So I was on a tangent there. I'm sorry.
But it was a Minecraft tangent, though, so I'm pretty sure it's okay.
It was really fun, and I thought it had a lot of possibilities to make a really good, small, like, niche community, because not everyone likes that type of gameplay. You can't really build. You're hiding, you know, but it was cool.
It sounds cool.
Yeah.
You got any big plans for this server? Are you just going to play, see the new stuff?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we need everything, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know. Start making the farms, I guess, you know.
Yeah.
Start with the
you in there, Jason.
Looking for some enchanting, start trapping in some zombies and convert them over to villagers so we can trade with them. Get all our stuff, huh?
Instead of finding See, I've never done that. I've always just ran around.
I never
and
did
found
it before
villages.
Either. Server was on before. The dude does it all the time, and he'll get a zombie spawner, and then, you know, and then he'll build, like, this, like, thing off of it to, like, just sit there, and he'll convert them with gold, you know, golden apples and whatever, and then if they don't trade well, he kills them. And then
what
if
a
they
jerk!
Have, and then if he has a good trade, he uses mine carts, and then has it all set up to, like, put heart, like, to totally corral them into a little stockade thing, and then he puts a sign up above them as to what their trades are and everything, and it was amazing. Like, we didn't need anything. Because then
right. You'd
get the farmers, so you could just trade with the farm, like, give them a bunch of, like, carrots, and then you get all this, all the gems? You know, the
diamonds?
Emeralds.
Emeralds.
Yeah, the emeralds.
Emeralds.
And then, you know, and then you go over to the other dude, and you enchant all your stuff. Or, you know, you get stuff that's already enchanted, top level. Like, it's awesome. Anyway.
Well, sounds good.
That's the way to do it. You just gotta find a village.
Sounds crazy difficult, too, though.
It's time-consuming. It's probably time-consuming. I mean, he did it all. I just reaped all the benefits.
Right.
Because I was spawned right next to his base, but...
And you're like, I picked the right plot to build on.
I was totally, assigned to the right team and zone and everything in that server, so... But anyway.
Nice.
But I learned a lot, so...
Well, good. We'll need that on the server. I'm limited to...
done it.
Like wheat farms and egg farms.
Yeah, I could do a wheat farm.
So I've got an egg farm running right now. We
okay.
just need to get some more stuff in there. Egg makers in there.
Yeah, I needed more iron. I could do that. I'll do that next.
No, anyway, yeah.
Just for the hoppers.
I dug it and replanted.
That's cool. So yeah, that was temporary. That was just to get it going. So it was fine.
Dang.
Anyway, for those listening, we totally just logged in today, so we were just kind of planting around the pond in Minecraft. So in Minecraft, you do have to plant food and feed yourself. So that's what we're talking about. In case you don't know what Minecraft is, it's a...
You've been living under a block.
I get it. It's a Trove clone, you know.
Definitely. Definitely Sky Circus. No, what was that one?
Skyforge.
Sky.
Was it Skyforge? No, not Skyforge.
No, Skyforge was like a combat game.
Yeah, that was the one. I know what you mean, though.
But yeah, they've been updating that. Like, I want to jump back in that and try that out because
I heard it's amazing. I just never played it.
They've done because you kind of have like your own island, but you can fly to other people's islands. I don't know. cool stuff.
Yeah. Sounds cool. Other thing I've been playing a lot of is Clash of Clans.
Some cock.
I've been playing... I can't say that. My son's in the next room.
It's an acronym.
Playing that. And, yeah. I started a Discord for our clan.
Oh, that would have been fun to be in
the
that.
One I booted you. I booted you out, didn't I?
I got kicked out.
Booted you. Yeah, you didn't play.
Did you get kicked out, Jason?
No, he's. You know why? He opts out of war.
Oh.
When he doesn't want a war.
I opted out for the longest time.
And then you opted in, and I'm like, is he really here? Is he really here? And I held you out, like, twice, because I'm like, I'm not sure if he's really here. And then, like, all right, he's still opted in. I'm going to let it go. And it's like, didn't go.
Well, I played. Like, I opted in, and then I didn't get in. And I was like, okay. And then I played one. And then the next one, it was like, I started, but it was like a weekend thing, and I just completely forgot. Completely my fault. Completely my fault.
Now we're doing Monday, Wednesday, so I think you'd be better at it.
I don't know. I think I would disappoint you sometime in the future.
No. What if I am more communicative?
No, that's not. I don't want to add more, like, stress to your life for a game. You know what I mean? Like, I may join and just not join up for the battles.
That's what I'm saying. Like, join in and just opt out. And then, you know what you could do? If you, because I start the wars every Monday, Wednesday. If you're like, no, I want a war, you could just tell me and I'll shove you in. I can make you play. I can make you opt in.
See why you like it hard now.
So that way you could just always stay opted out and I'll manage it. But yeah.
So have y'all been kicking ass though in the wars, right?
Nope.
Oh.
Nope, not at all.
No,
that is not true. We're trying to hit our 30th, and we've now hit our third loss in a row.
Ooh.
It's been brutal, because we actually had 100% participation this war, too. And just, we're close. Just right. Can't.
That's like,
yeah. I mean, but, yeah, it's fun, because there's a challenge there, and everyone's participating, and everyone's trying. And I think we finally fostered the right group with the right expectations. Like, we try and we do our best, but we're casual. And if we don't win, it doesn't ruin our day. We just like, all right, well, we start a new one on Monday. So.
And everybody do better.
Yeah, right now, actually, this weekend, we're having an event called Chaos Weekend. And it's what I occasionally what I do with the clan is I'll open it up to instead of invite only to join the clan, it is a free for all. It is anyone can join. And I bump it down to 600 trophies. So like pretty much any newbie could. I mean, you don't have to be like that into the game to hit 600 trophies.
Is that just because you want to have a horrible weekend?
Yeah, everyone jumps, like, we're not warring or anything, so, like, everyone pile. There's people coming and going, and donate max troops to me, and then I give them a bunch of gobos, like, I said I need max troops, please only, and, like, but you're just here to hop, you're here right. to take all my junk and hop, so, and then we chat with some of them who will chat, and we joke around, but then, like, right now it's kind of quiet, because I don't know why, actually. It's been quiet since probably 5 o'clock, but my time, p.m. But, yeah, so it's just something crazy to do. Sometimes you find some new people in the community that didn't have a home, and it's just kind of fun. And I kind of I post on the official forum, so if, like, people just want to come and, like, chat and say hello and stuff and from other clans, then they can hop out on Sunday and go back to their home clan. Like, it's more of a come meet and greet type of thing, but right. We get all this
open
crazy
house.
Huh?
A little open house.
Yeah,
put
yeah.
Put out some
exactly.
goblin odors. I don't know how to say that word.
We also get absolute chaos because we get people hopping in and out and yelling at us for not donating their max troops that they want. It's like, oh, that's not really what we're doing. I know we're probably representing ourselves, but I don't really care. It's chaos. Ah! Part of the event.
Sounds good.
It is. It's nuts. It's a train wreck, but it's, you know, like a train wreck, you're going to watch. So you're on that chat for the weekend.
So, but speaking of apps, you quit Pokemon Go?
I didn't quit.
I heard you deleted it.
Nope. I didn't delete it. Nope.
Nope.
I still got my Twitter going for it. My illegal Twitter is still a rockin'. But I only probably open it up as I'm going into work and going out of work because there's a thingy there.
Oh, yeah. A spinny thingy.
That's it. Yeah.
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 I broke down and bought one of these things.
Is it awesome?
It is awesome. And
what does it do? Like, so, tell me why it's awesome.
It's not really for, like, if you're going out actively playing the game. It is not for that. And
that could be good, because if I just want to go for a run.
Yeah, it'd be great for a run. So, like, I use it in the car, because you don't want to be looking at your app while you're driving, right? But this thing just buzzes, so you just, yeah. No, you don't want to be looking. You really don't. That's, anyway, but now I don't have to, because this thing buzzes. So when a Pokemon comes into range, it buzzes and lets you know, and then you click it, and it throws one ball. That's the other thing I love.
You don't have to try?
No, it just throws a ball automatically, but you either get it or it runs away, or either it flees. So you only get one chance to get it.
Okay, so that's okay. That seems fair.
And it's a pretty, I would say it's like about a 60 to 70% of the time I catch them.
All right.
Seems pretty high. Like, I'm running out of, but it only uses your red and white balls. It doesn't use your higher ones.
Ooh.
And so I keep running out of balls, but the good thing is it does the Pokestops too. So I just drive around downtown, and every time you pass one, it buzzes again, and you just click it, and it auto spins.
Dude, there's like over 50 Pokestops on the campus I work.
Yeah. So like while you're running, you just have that in your hand running.
Run at work, but yeah, I know what you mean. Like if I went for a walk at lunch or something, it would just be like going off all the time.
Yeah, and you just click it, and that's what I love is like now if I'm out at a bar with a friend and there's a Pokestop there, I don't have to like have my phone out and like every once in a while look over and do anything. And just click it.
Yeah, well, that's genius. Because, yeah, that was actually...
You're going robot.
It's like I have to make sure it stays, like it's draining battery down to nothing, and I had like two battery packs with me all times. And
I think either my internet's dying or y'all's is.
Oh, can you hear me?
You're like a robot.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Are you there, Jason? Jason's done. He left. Uh-oh. I think everybody left. I wonder if that's my internet's. There's a problem connecting you. Are you connected to the internets? Am I connected to the internets? I don't know if I'm connected to the internets. I am connected to the internet, so it's not me. It's not me, but I'll refresh this just in case. And there it blinks around, and there's a dude doing something in my ear. Don't do that in my ear. Stop it. That's Steve. I will do that. So, I guess that's an MMO show. I don't know if I should wait for people to join back in. Or not. Is the stream going? I'll check that. / Go Kart Brothers. Well, how about this? It looks like they're down. The show's still going on. There's an ad playing on my Twitch, but I'm pretty sure someone pulled the plug over there. The internets are down for Michigan, so we'll see you next week. Find us, Go Kart Brothers or the MMO Show, everywhere. Just search for it. Find it. And, oh, no, she's back.
I was just going to text you.
So y'all's internets are back.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. Just like blinked.
That's okay.
They're mad at us.
The internets are? All of them?
Our internet is probably mad at us. We canceled our cable TV.
Oh, cutting the cord?
We kept the Wi-Fi. Yeah, we kept all the internet.
Cut the cord.
Y'all need to get a Nexus player and look into a thing called Kodi. K-O-D-I.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
And Exodus is an app that goes on it.
Why?
I might want to pull the stream down before I start talking about it.
Oh. I don't want to do that then.
I heard about it from Drew up at the Bachelor Party, too. I don't want to do that.
I
know what it is.
I will say this. Technically, it's not illegal yet.
I don't like any of this.
It's kind of like Napster before Napster was shut down.
No, we're not doing that.
But even less so illegal.
Nope.
So I guess we can talk about it, right? We're not telling people to do it.
But just so you know
what it is.
Yeah, I guess it's okay because you have one person that's saying, like, don't do it.
Yeah, so you're saying don't do it, but that's cool. Yeah,
it's
don't do this.
It's ethically wrong.
Possibly. And I guess depending on your ethics, I don't know, morally,
like having
ethically,
some versus not having some?
I don't know. Is it ethical to charge me $100 to take my kids to a movie theater? I don't know. Anyway, but it basically what it does is, you know, there's a bunch of websites out there that stream content, and this thing basically scrapes those streams, and so then you can watch basically anything that's on those, like The Fall Guy, right?
The Fall Guy.
Where else are you going to see The Fall Guy, right?
Jesus
Cody.
Christ. That's what you come up with.
Have you been watching The Fall Guy lately?
Not lately, but I did.
Your fair share of Fall Guy, though, right?
In the last month, have you been watching Fall Guy?
No. I haven't. If it was on, I will say this: the Fall Guy didn't come through when I tried to watch it on there.
But
it was a few months ago.
Yep.
But if it was on Netflix, man, I'd watch all of the Fall Guy.
Yeah. You love The Fall Guy.
I
watched it growing up. That and what was it? BJ the Bear.
BJ and the Bear was good. Yeah.
Never seen it.
They were terrible. It was just terrible. But I liked it too.
A trucker with a monkey.
Yeah, Jason, it's right up your alley.
Yeah, no, it sounds really fucking good, but I've never seen it.
You'll have to get Cody and try it out, see if it's on there. You probably watch Airwolf.
Yeah.
I would not watch Airwolf.
Oh, I'd watch my ass some werewolf.
I'm not watching
some
werewolf.
Like, they need to redo it. Like, W-A-I-R, werewolf.
Spell it, yeah.
Werewolf, and then he hops out of the plane on a full moon and turns into a werewolf.
He's a werewolf who works on a helicopter.
He's a man who turns into a wolf helicopter.
Oh, God, he's like a transformer now.
He's a dude who turns into a werewolf, but the awesome thing is, they bring it in a serious, like, battle situations, like some really dark shit, and they push him off the helicopter, and as he's in the air about to go into the shit, he turns into a werewolf.
No.
They drop a werewolf from Airwolf.
It's called Werewolf.
Right, but it's it's spelled like where-AIR wolf.
Yeah, Brent
maybe
just
it's
said that.
Maybe
yeah.
It's like a shepherd and they can't find the wolf.
No.
W-H-E-R-E wolf. Werewolf
from the actual Airwolf helicopter.
Maybe they could use the pink screaming Mimi from that other show with the two detectives. Remember that one?
You're not getting it. It's gold. You're taking away from the pureness of it. It's
right,
a
right.
werewolf being dropped from.
Well, Jason, you know, this is gonna. I can already tell this explanation is gonna take so long. I'm gonna make a beverage, and you guys discuss werewolf.
I think we're already kind of past
that.
Right,
as long as he admits
so that.
No, you got a perfect.
My version is the pure version. We're okay.
It's. I love it. It's like, just okay. Like the awl guy, and he has like a little awl, like one of those tools, AWL. Is that how he's calling it? The awl guy?
I don't know what you're talking about.
And someone goes, hey, do you have an awl? And he goes, I do. And so they go, it's the awl guy. I'm not. But I'm not named with pity. I'm the dumpa-dumpa-dumpa-who. I can't remember the lyrics. I jump from a burning building.
I vaguely remember Fall Guy.
But I'm the unknown stuntman who makes Clint Eastwood look so fine. That's all I got.
I remember the intro. I don't remember actually watching the show. I mostly remember the intro being on and me being like, God damn it, why isn't like A-Team on or something?
Oh, man. Yeah. I don't know why I like this. Well, it probably at the time had a lot to do with like, was it Heather Locklear? Wasn't she on there? No, Heather Thomas.
I would say that would have been really early for Heather Locklear.
She was on Top of Cars at that point, I think.
Yeah, she was like music video.
Or, wait, that's Tawny Kitaen.
That's Tawny Kitaen. White Snake. Yeah.
The Space Track dude was on Top of the Cars, and Heather Locklear was chasing the car in another police car.
Oh, TJ Hooker?
Hey, now. I don't think that's right to.
She was in TJ Hooker, though.
Oh, that's the name of the show.
Yes. You want to talk about awful shows like Fall Guy? TJ Hooker's right there.
Fall Guy? What are you talking about? Fall Guy was awesome.
Okay.
Chips? Did you do a chips?
Yeah, I would partake of some chips.
So are we all okay with Werewolf now?
Yes. Yeah, he's totally on board with my vision.
Okay.
I am. We're already working on the first script.
Can you catch me up to where we're at?
Crappy show, you came in.
Awesome. I am now beveraging on Bacardi and Diet Verner's because I didn't want to go downstairs and get a Diet Pepsi.
Is there a name for a drink like that?
Usually I use Verner's, and Verner's is a very, it's generally considered a stronger ginger ale. When I was little, like Verner's was local and it had a more,
it's the green can.
Much more. Yeah. But it had a really potent ginger. Like it would almost like, it was like almost like take your breath away. It was like really potent ginger taste. And then when they went like national, they really watered it down. Like I miss old Verner's because that's what I grew up on for ginger ale. But anyway, Verner's. Canada Dry tastes like watered down stuff to me. But anyway, so if you take Verner's and Captain Morgan, it's called a Captain's Cove is what a local restaurant around here calls it. I'm not sure if it's a real thing or not, but so I'm thinking Bacardi and Diet Verner's is about as good as I can do right tonight because I'm out of Captain.
Okay.
So that's pretty good. I like Bacardi.
Old Verner's. I like Bacardi too. That's what I'm drinking, but I'm doing it with Diet A&W. So a little throwback to old Slurmsy because he likes the old.
He loves that.
Papa's River. This is like not your grandma's root beer, I think.
Something you're making like your own, not your father's. Yeah.
Yeah. Verner's. I keep putting images on our screen. We're like a race car, like a racing go-kart.
There's more and more stuff. Let's see.
Is there more stuff?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I think, I don't know. I haven't watched any movies lately. I've been watching a lot of wrestling, which I know Slurms isn't like when we talk about that.
The wrestling?
Oh my God. Yeah, I like wrestling. Jason likes wrestling. So we just watched there's a documentary series on the WWE Network, and it goes through the wrestling wars, like the station war. What's it called? That's the official thing for it. It's WWE versus WCW. The what? Monday Night War. Yeah. Because it was like one of these situations where both wrestling companies both had airtime at the exact same time and the exact same night of the week. And it's like they went head to head for years and it was just this huge ratings war and it brought out the best. Like it was just awesome stuff that came out. And so they did this documentary once the wars concluded. WWE did a documentary series on that whole time and like all the things contributed to those Monday Night Wars, and we just got through watching that documentary series, and it's really
just talking
fun.
About
it was really fun.
Everything that happened.
It's one of those things, huh? Sorry.
Just talking about everything that happened during that time.
Yeah, and like all the things that contributed to like who was winning and why and how it went down, and it was really fun to watch because I was watching back then. So as you know, it was fun to like see like. Remember like what I was seeing on screen and then like what was actually happening like
right.
in the background. But anyway, that covers our wrestling portion because no one likes to hear about that.
I think it's fine. It's interesting to hear what's going on in the wrestling world.
Mm-hmm.
What's even better is looking up images. Just search for WWE. That's all you need. I will tell you, don't search. I keep a tweet deck open with hashtag Overwatch. So when we're doing the Overwatch podcast, I can see what's going on.
There's
you gotta watch out. For some reason, there's people who like to do like Overwatch hentai.
What's that?
Hentai. I don't know how to say it. It's basically like the cartoon porn. And all of a sudden, I'll just be sitting there, and on my tweet deck, you see like May nude doing like stuff you don't want to see, and it's like, oh my god, what's going on?
Oh my god, I gotta tuck my prick.
And it's like, then I gotta like turn off the webcam and
tug your prick and turn it back on.
It's just
make sure you're not recording or streaming.
It's just awful. The worst thing in the world. So yeah, just hashtag Overwatch, hashtag porn will get you there if you need that fix. This isn't your anyway. Sorry.
What?
That I went there. Probably shouldn't have gone there, but I don't know.
Jason was waiting for someone to go there. He just likes saying all that stuff, so it's fine.
I don't know about that.
We were giving you a wrestling hat. There we go. We were talking about what to call the beverage I'm having, and chat tonight says we will call it the Shannon. And I like that. I like that a lot, because it's all about me.
Yeah.
I like me.
Someone's got to.
The Vernanen.
Yeah. I actually had a drink I made Shannon. When I was 21. I wasn't 21 yet, but I when I was 21, and it was a shot of bluesberry.
Bluesberry. Is that like...
Yeah. It's a blueberry
Blues Brothers?
Liquor. It was a blueberry liquor. Like almost a schnapps, like a blueberry schnapps type of deal. And then it was a shot of Absolut, and I wouldn't recommend using Absolut now, but I was like, you know, young and
it was in the cabinet.
It was in someone's cabinet, and
okay.
And a shot of blue. Is it Caraco or Curacao?
Curacao sounds right.
I've heard Curacao, and then I've been told I was wrong. But anyway, so that, and then you do fill the glass with, you know, you have, then you fill the glass with ice, and then you do the rest with Sprite. It was really good. There's oranges and blueberries, and it was awesome.
Sounds good. Normally,
I called it Absolutely Shannon. That's why I had to use Absolute. But...
Huh. It's a very catchy name.
Yeah, well, not really, because it made no sense. Like, I needed something like blue and orange, like, because it was blueberry and orange flavors, but I didn't, because I was an egomaniac back then, not now.
Called like Absolutely Bill's, was it Bill's Mood? What was that They Might Be Giants song? Absolutely.
It's Birdhouse in Your Soul. It has nothing to do with any of that.
I'm your only friend. I'm not your only friend, but I'm a little glowing friend. But really, I'm not actually your friend, but I am.
That's our outro. That's our outro.
Who watches over you?
Gonna make a little birdhouse.
Just bring
in
it
your
down.
Soul.
Little birdhouse in your soul. Sorry.
Anyway, it's a real song, ladies and gentlemen. You're too young and you don't know it. Go look it up. Great song.
There's only two songs in me, and I just wrote the third. Don't know where I got the inspiration or how I wrote the words.
I thought it was going to rhyme with turd some reason.
Spent my whole life just digging up my music shallow grave. There's just two songs in me and the third one I just made. Dun, 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 dun. It's another one of theirs.
Another one. I like it.
They were.
We do have a lot of graffiti on our backdrop. I love it. I love how it's a visual represent. It's like it's our visual show notes. That's what that
right.
is.
Like, I like quit it. Writing shit down. Just look at the last screen and go, oh, they're going to talk about some half nude dude.
There's my internet tags right there. Bam, bam, bam.
So, yeah, I guess that's the end of the show.
Jason, yeah, you want to talk about some stuff? I was away for like all of your talking, apparently.
Oh, we talked about a lot of awful stuff. It was great.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Hair of the wolf dog.
All right. Well, yeah, we're done. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us this evening.
Bye.
You're welcome.